This week, Phasm turns 25. At the same time, it's been 15 years since I first announced what Phasm 2 would be like. And after all this time, nobody's really waiting for it anymore. But it's here, and I wanted to show you. So, let's take it out. It's going to take a few seconds. Now we have a Windows version here. Yes, we really want it. And it's just an old editor with Phasm 2 integrated instead of Phasm 1. We have very few examples here. In fact, only one example for Windows. Let me change the font to something bigger. And as usual, you can just compile and run the example. But we can have more examples because we can just take Phasm 1. And because Phasm 2 is to a large extent compatible with Phasm 1, we can just assemble many of the old examples just as they are. And so we can take dialogue example, and it's going to work out of the box. And OpenGL examples should also work. The one that is not going to work is this one. We get an error because Phasm 2 does not support the brace syntax for macros. We need to change this to the modern syntax. And there is another place down here. And with this tiny change, we can get the example to assemble. Another one that is going to give us errors is this one. And we have many errors here that seem to indicate that some variables were not defined. But if we scroll down to the end of this list, we see the main error, which is the source of all the errors. Iterate is a reserved word in Phasm 2. Because this starts an iterated block. And because this block is never closed, this is why any definitions that happen later are not processed correctly. We could change this name to something else, but we have another simpler option. We can just put a question mark before the name. To force the assembler to treat it as a label and not an instruction. And now the example assembles correctly. So let's go back here. We also have a command line version, which is just a shell script, and we have a bash script for Linux. So let's go to Linux and check it out. We need to find this directory. If we execute the bash script, we can see that it starts fasmg under the hood. Let's go to the examples and assemble an example. Now we can execute this example. And it works because we are on Windows file system. Normally we would have to add executable attribute to the file. And similarly, FASM2 in this Windows version has FASMG integrated into it with some additional configuration. It includes FASM2 headers. So if we remove this line and make it not use the FASM2 headers, we can just use it with any other FASMG projects. And in fact, let me switch to my second machine. As you can see, this one is an ARM machine. It's Windows on ARM. And FASM2 is working because Windows on ARM has an excellent x86 emulation. But the example that I have opened here is an ARM example. It's the one that I posted on the message board some time ago. You can see that instead of standard format PE, we have PE formatters set up manually to change all the fields needed for ARM architecture. And we also have an instruction set for ARM that was implemented by Jacobly, not by me. And because this is an ARM machine, we can just execute the example. But because this is still FASM2 and it's by default includes the FASM2 headers, we are still going to get x86 instructions, and the new instructions defined by this additional header are going to be on top of x86 instructions. So even though MOV instruction is the ARM instruction now, because it is replaced, some other instructions that are not ARM instructions, like MOVZX for example, may still be assembled. And this, of course, this may be unwanted. So we can go to the compiler setup, remove the FASM2 headers, and now we have raw FASMG, and we can execute. Well, we are still missing some instructions like align, because FASM2 is including them, and now we need to include them manually. So now we have no x86 instructions, and this is pure ARM code. We can even add some breakpoint debug the program. And so this is how we can use FASM2 and also just a FASMG in general. And that's all I wanted to show this time. Thank you for watching.